Señores, llegó un momento histórico, histórico para el Cuartel del Metal. Estoy acá con José, que bueno, se puso la 10 y consiguió la mejor entrevista, una de las mejores entrevistas que hemos tenido. No sé, ¿hubo alguna mejor algún día? ¿O esta es la mejor que ha tocado en tanto tiempo?
Yo creo que es la mejor en mucho tiempo, pero yo cuando entrevistaba, te digo 2009, 2010, sí llegué a hablar con Ian Gillan, y también con Fenriz, también con Fenriz de Dark,
Uf.
de Dark Throne.
No, bueno, hay de
Pero
todo,
hay de todo.
pero
Yo creo que esta ha sido, o sea, viviendo un momento actual, yo creo que la más grande que ha pasado por el canal y por la historia
sí.
de la web.
Definitivamente. No, no, no los vamos a aburrir mucho porque ya sabemos lo que ustedes quieren ver. Dave Mustaine en minutos, acá en segundos, en entrevista. Pequeño disclaimer, no salió en video, así que esto va a estar montado con imágenes, con videos de la banda tocando en vivo. Y la entrevista fue puntual para Colombia. Hablamos en general de cosas que le van a interesar a todos, argentinos, chilenos, peruanos, mexicanos. A todos les va a interesar lo que tiene para decir. Hay una exclusiva, ojo ahí, una exclusiva sobre el setlist. Ya no, no les adelanto más nada que lo va a mencionar. Y no sé, ¿algo más que quieras decir? Estoy muy emocionado.
Pues nada, que la disfruten mucho. Es una entrevista que la verdad no sabíamos que iba a llegar. Llegó de un momento a otro. Fede, no queremos
Vamos.
más de tiempo. Da la
Con
orden tú.
ustedes, Dave Mustaine. Ya. Hello, Dave. How are you? Really nice to meet
Good.
you.
You too, buddy. How are you?
Doing fine, thank you. A huge honor for me to talk to you today. So thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Okay, well, Dave, so you're returning to Colombia after many years with two shows at the Movistar Arena, 21st and 22nd of April. First show has been sold out for a long time, so congratulations on that. Also, you're selling shows fast throughout South America as well. You know, you've always been very big in this part of the world, but now it feels that you're even bigger than ever. So, how are you feeling concerning these upcoming shows in Colombia?
Feeling pretty fat. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. Yeah, I agree. You know, we seem to be bigger now than we ever have. And I love the fact that our relationship with Latin America just continues to grow. We started off with just a few nations down there. Of course, you remember, you were one of them. It was, at the beginning was made up of Argentina and Chile and Brazil with Rock in Rio, and then when Colombia got added. It was kind of like the big four, and you know, that was it for us. We had arrived. We had conquered the equator. We had gone past. We'd gone into Central America, and we had gone down to one of the most amazing, passionate places in the planet. And to play for the fans in Colombia, for American bands that haven't had a chance to come down there and experience it, you don't know what you're missing. It's like trying to explain an orgasm to a virgin.
All right. Well, that's great to hear from your end. And well, this time you're coming with a renewed, well, not that renewed because Dirk has been for a long time, and of course James has rejoined the band after a few years. But for example, in Colombia, this will be the first time for Dirk, I think, and for Temu in all of South America with Megadeth, right? So, when you get maybe a new musician in the band, do you tell them anything about what Colombia, what South America is like, about the crowd, maybe the energy, how excited are they as well? Because you already know it well, right?
Sure, of course. How could I not? I get so excited. I just bubble with enthusiasm about going down there, and you know, I can't help myself with the excitement. Getting to the airport, pretty much can tell you from the minute I get out of the car at the curb until I get into the plane seat. I am like focused like a laser to go straight to that seat because I am so excited to go. You know, it's not like that all the time. Sometimes when you're going on tour, you're going to a place that's a little hard to play, a little cold. Maybe the economy isn't great. Maybe the fans there. don't have great places for bands to come and play for them, you know, but that doesn't matter for the fans that really love the band that they are a fan of. And I think when musicians lose sight of that, they should stop.
Okay, great. So, glad to always hear you're so excited to come and play to this part of the world. I think fans really appreciate that. And as we said, two shows in Colombia. There'll be some songs from your latest record, I presume, Seek the Dying and the Dead. Since its release, you've been performing We'll Be Back and Soldier On. So could we maybe hear any song of this album that you haven't performed live yet, maybe?
Sure. In fact, we've been discussing that a lot. It's just when we can make that happen. We've got to get together as a band. The four of us are all around the planet right now. Timu's in Switzerland, mm-hmm. James Berker in California somewhere, and I'm in Tennessee.
Yeah.
So.
Okay, but it's a part of the discussion, so.
Yes, we
awesome.
Have been talking.
Looking forward to checking out which one of those you will have for us ready. So awesome.
I can tell you what song we're gonna try and add the title track.
Awesome.
I think there was two songs, Soldier On and We'll Be Back. I think there was a third song we were noodling around with. But we're trying to do as much as we can, but with the intensity of this music, we just can't really play longer than 90 minutes.
Right.
And when you reach that shutting down period, you know, it doesn't matter how hard you try. When you reach that 90 minute area, it's kind of like, you know, the bottle is empty.
Mm-hmm.
Genie's out of the bottle.
Right. And you gotta have the classics. You cannot not play your longtime classics as well.
Problem is so many songs are becoming classics too.
Right.
That's a good have though.
Of Dystopia, I mean the title track's already a classic, I think, Fatal Illusion. I mean you can name a lot from 2000s forward Megadeth era that have already reached that milestone, right?
Yeah.
So that's awesome. Concerning the latest record as well, I'm sure you've been told this a lot, but the chart positions also don't lie. This has been one of the greatest, well-received Megadeth records in years. So, looking back to the making of it, to what do you attribute that? Maybe the heaviness and the thrashier aspects of songs like Night Stalkers or We'll Be Back, the overall feel of the album. I mean, to what do you think made this album so great? Because it's really an amazing record.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. I don't know what to attribute that to other than the fact that when we were together, you know, we started that with two other people and then we had to make a change and we brought in another bass player and then we needed to make another change and we ended up now with what I feel is one of my favorite Megadeth lineups ever because Kiko is so very talented and he plays so many different melodic styles. He was able to do a lot of stuff. Sometimes we would talk about songs and he wasn't aware of any of those songs. But Timu is, so he's a little bit more from the metal,
right?
The metal background, but they're both, I mean, guitar players at that level. Good God, are you kidding me?
Yeah.
I've always been lucky and hired really, well, not lucky. I've always been really fortunate and hired great guitar players, but Timu is at the top of his game. He's the best of the best. And I'm grateful for Kiko recommending Timo.
Mm-hmm. Well, Dave, a couple of years ago, of course, we had the pandemic. You also had to deal with a with a cancer that fortunately you've fully recovered now. So I'm guessing touring must have become something more demanding. Correct me if I'm wrong, but you know, you're still going very strong, playing lots of shows around the world. Here in South America, you don't only play like the obvious countries like Colombia, Argentina, Chile, but you also go to Paraguay, to Peru, that most metal bands maybe at times skip, right? So how are you coping with that intensity of touring nowadays, especially in South America, that you get to, it's a lot of flights every day, right? And that kind of touring intensity.
How do I cope with it?
Yeah.
Well, there's no coping. That to me, the word cope means that you're dealing with something. You're getting by. You're
Oh,
bearing.
okay. So how do you live through it? Maybe. How's the day, your experience?
I'm a very happy person right now with what's going on in my career. I think the tour is going great, not only in South America, but over in Europe as well. And we'll be going to North America after we come back from Europe this summer. So everything is really looking up for us. In fact, so much so that I started 2 weekends ago, and it was just 1 day a week. I'm just kind of slowly sharpening the knives, but I started listening to some ideas, and I had our record producer come over and start cleaning house with me for a new record.
Wow,
we
awesome.
didn't we're not we're not we're not writing a new record yet.
Okay.
We're just kind of doing some cleaning up and getting ready for the next tour. Because, you know, we want to make sure, Federico, that we don't leave any little pieces of a potential new song. You know, say I'm recording on The Sick, the Dying, and the Dead, and I have an idea. What I usually do, we'll say to Chris Rakestraw, our record producer, I'll say, go to the end, Chris, and that means fast forward or scroll forward on the Pro Tools track to a clear spot. Let me do my idea and then go back to where we were working. So that means that a lot of songs that are actual songs with different titles, you know, I think you mentioned Celebutante or somebody else did that earlier. That is a song that I bet there's a lot of little pieces at the end, because of how many ideas we had cranking around at that time. So once we get that stuff out of the way, we'll be able to really start digging in. But, you know, that's what I've been doing all week, is getting ready to start working with Chris again. And Chris is out on the road with us too. So our live engineer is a person named Stanley Source. And he has been recording every show that we've ever done since I hired him. So we could realistically go back in time, any concert, anywhere, and pull out any song that we might have played if someone wanted it. But right now, we're focusing on making our new show the best show we've ever possibly had, sound-wise, look-wise, feeling-wise.
Awesome. Well, great to hear. And I've also, well, in a recent interview, stated some anniversaries of some records that are coming up, like the 25 years of Rust in Peace, for example, next year. So maybe you have some special touring in mind, as well as maybe starting, not working on a new record, as you say, but maybe start to put together some ideas alongside with maybe another special tour or stuff like that.
Sure, that sounds like it'd be a great idea. I think you and I are on the same wavelength here. You know, if we're not touring, we want to be doing something. If we're not writing a new record, write a book. If we're not doing a book, write a documentary. If we're not doing that, let's go see how we can help other people, maybe some other bands, maybe some other musicians that need some mentor work, maybe some volunteer work with charity. But to sit back and let all this success that I've been given, not to use that to help other people, it's kind of fucked up.
Yeah, well, you're always doing something. That's great to hear. And just to start wrapping up the interview, because I know that you're also a guy that likes to visit different touristic places. In an interview last year, you said that in Peru, I don't know if this time will be the moment to do it, but you were Maybe looking forward to knowing Machu Picchu and, well, maybe certain other places in South America. Are you getting some days off so you can get to know the places a little bit? Of course, maybe you already know some countries very well. You've been here many times, but or is it just focusing on the touring this time?
Well, I wish I had more time because I would love to go see Machu Picchu as well as Easter Island. But my priority right now is to give the fans in Latin America one of the greatest concerts of their lives.
Fantastic. Well, Dave, thanks a lot for your time today. It really means a lot. If there's any last words you'd like to dedicate to your Colombian fans and also your South American fans concerning your upcoming tour.
To all of our fans in South America, especially our fans in Colombia, we love you so very much and we cannot wait to come back. And if I remember how to say this right, son grosos, sepernos.
That sounded pretty well. So, well, Dave, huge honor for me. Thank you very much and see you in April.
All right, hermano. Ciao.
Okay, bye bye.